doing today?
Great. How are you?
You know, we're ha- is it Wednesday? It's Wednesday. We're happy. My days are all mixed up during this pandemic.
Same.
What day, what week, what year, what month? It just is what it is. But I just want to thank both of you, first of all, for just making me smile while watching Chemical Hearts, because I was this close from watching your characters to actually wanting to be in a relationship again, because that's how much just joy and hope that you ladies gave with your characters.
Yay. So, thank you. Thank you for saying that.
Yes.
No, seriously, I literally had a smile on my face every time that I see your characters kind of come in contact with one another. And I really wanted to ask you, just from representation, it is so nice to see beautiful different shades of melanin, but also representing the LGBT community. And so I really wanted to know, how was it portraying these characters and what really attracted you to these roles?
It was just so fulfilling. I mean, Kara and I were both free thinkers. We're both radicals. We like to shake things up. And so when something like this comes along, and then you also get to partner with someone who kind of thinks in that way, it's exciting. It's so special for kids to have, to see a movie like this and see themselves. That's everything.
Yeah. I completely agree. I think it's incredibly important for young people to see a young person being so unapologetically Black and free and taking up space in the world and without judgment of themselves, and will never doubt themselves and will give themselves the permission to evolve, which I feel like Law is totally that. And also like just kind of getting into the fact that these characters truly express themselves of how they feel, which I feel like is very important to these kind of narratives.
You know, one of the things that just strikes me is how mature, you know, your characters, they're all in high school, but they just have this sense of maturity. Or, you know, in today's society, I think we forget how with this new generation, that they have to grow up so much faster than the previous generations before. And I really wanted to ask you, for your characters, since we do deal with relationships, do you think that as a society, we kind of stifle the younger generation from really being, it's almost like they don't want them to feel sure about themselves. You know, Coral, your character is so sure about what she wants at that time. And Kara, even for yours, they've done the work, they've tried to be with other people, but they know who they want to be with. And so I just wanted to get your perspective on that. And Kara, we can start with you.
I do think that, first of all, I think we need to put more respect on young people.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because young people are the movement, just FYI, just throwing that out there. And young people have a lot of radical ideas about how to change the world. That's number one. So I think that the way that we push certain agendas on young people, it will stifle them, because it's what they're seeing, what they have access to, is what they're going to emulate. And I think we just need to reverse all of that. That's kind of how I feel about that, but I could go on for hours about this. So I'm gonna shoot that to Coral.
You gotta give us a word.
Yeah, I just think, you know, the adults keep making messes and kids keep having it up. It's not fair, because that's the job, is to clean for them to be messy. And there's a lot, there's much going on. I'm so proud of younger generations.
Well, ladies, thank you so much for taking the time to speak with me today. I really appreciate it.
Oh, Sharonda, so lovely to meet you. You look stunning.
Stunning.
No, you look stunning. I'm just happy to be in your presence.
Same here.